If you're going to criticize somebody, you should always walk a mile in their shoes first. Because then when you do criticize them, you'll be a mile away and you'll have their shoes. That, I think, is pretty damn good advice. First of all, let me ask, Nicolette, where are you? What's your heart rate? 92. And Richard. Oh, no, Richard is good. Richard said, Richard. He knew I forgot his name, so he, Richard. Okay, good. Richard, thanks. What's your heart rate? Well, come on up here a second, Richard. Was 92. Yours was 92. Come on up, Nicolette. Richard, over here. Nicolette, over here. Where are you from, Richard? And you're from?
Prince George.
Prince George. Okay. What's your heart rate now, Richard?
Holy shoot.
113.
159. Oh, my goodness. 167.
167. Okay, now. Everyone just be very calm, hands, just jiggle your hands a minute. I want you to do a diaphragmatic breathing. Just breathe into the base of your lungs, four counts. I'm going to count for you. Just smile on your face, breathe in. One, two, three, four. Breathe out through your mouth. One, all the way down to the base of three, four. Huge breath in, breathe in. One, two, three, four. Breathe out. One, two. Three, four. What's your heart rate now?
92.
So you dropped 70 beats. What's yours? 102. From? 113. Pretty interesting, isn't it? Now, what happened? Was it the workload? I mean, I think that's at least 30 steps up here. And I like to show this because it kind of ends up this thing that everything we do physically works into how we are mentally and emotionally. Everything we do mentally and emotionally also affects us physiologically. And I know when I sold real estate, sometimes in that 3 to 5 period, the sun's out, you're driving someone to see another building or another house, 4 in the afternoon, this is the 13th, and you say, I don't care. I don't care if they buy a house or not. I want them out of the car. Persistence is one of my favorite things. There was this guy, hears the doorbell ring, goes to the door, opens it up, nobody's out there. He looks down, there's a snail on his welcome mat. Leans over, picks up the snail, throws it into the street, goes back in. 6 months later, doorbell rings. Goes to the door, opens it up, no one's there. Looks down, there's the snail. Snail looks up and says, what the hell was that all about? Is that persistence or what? I mean, you think of that journey of that poor little snail. But persistence follows optimism. It's not the other way around. You don't build persistence. You build optimism. My job as managing a group of people is to build optimism. If I believe my actions are going to result in success, I'll keep doing them. Persistence comes naturally. We're going to start now a little bit on the physical fitness side. And I want you to think of this. I am not a physical fitness guru. We have worked for 20 years with the best scientists in the world. We know what we're talking about. But I don't want you to think I'm here to help you get a set of ripped abs. I'm here to help you sell more and have a happier life at the same time. And the reason we got into this was because we began to see it has so much to do with what kind of a great life you can carve out for yourself. I don't even care if you live longer because you exercise. I care that you enjoy each moment more because you're more in the world. Your body is ready. You can take stress and play with it instead of getting borne down by it. How many here have heard of Stephen Wright? I knew Barry would have. The comedian. Stephen Wright, the comedian. Okay, hey, this group is humor deprived. I mean, we have got to do some work here. Stephen Wright wakes up one day, everything in his apartment had been stolen and replaced with an exact replica. He said to his girlfriend, how could they do this to me? She said, how do I know it's you? He got a new dog, he named him Stay. Come here, Stay. His poor dog's schizophrenic, you know. doesn't know what to do. For his birthday recently, he got a humidifier and a dehumidifier. Put them in the same room and let them fight it out. He says, what do batteries run on? Why is the alphabet in that order? Is it because of that song? He built a skylight in his place. Neighbors upstairs are furious. He says, if you have multiple personalities and you're trying to commit suicide, is that a hostage situation? Well, what I love about Stephen Wright is he's a comedian of change. He forces you from left brain into right brain. The right brain is the conceptual, the creative side of the brain. And we work so hard, it's so often in the Apollo, rational, left brain, logical, linear, sequential side of the brain. Business is based on that. But what we forget is the creativity aspect comes when we join both sides of the brain. And that is when we're living a good life that we really enjoy.